To the most beautiful women of Asia and the Pacific region, coming together in the spirit of peace, unity, and understanding. This is the quest for Miss Asia Pacific 2001.
Woman, you're more precious than gold. Woman, you're the glory untold. You're a jewel, a friend, a joy till the end. You're a darling all far. I'm so glad that you are my heavenly star.
Gentlemen, presenting the candidates vying for the title of Miss Asia Pacific 2001.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Chanel Gregory, and tonight I'm honored to be representing the land down under, Australia. Gentlemen, my name is Sandra Glover. I am 20 years old and proud to represent the country of smiles, El Salvador.
everybody. My name is Marcela Rubí and I represent Team the Hell of Central America, Honduras.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Maheshwari. I'm 21 years old and I come from the land of love, peace, harmony, and beautiful women, India.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Naomi Numata. I'm 23 years old. I come from beautiful island of Japan.
Nice to meet you. My name is Jae Kim. I'm 23 years old. I'm from beautiful country, Korea. Thank you very much.
My name is Chantal. I am 20 years old. I come from the pearl of the Middle East, Lebanon.
My name is Violet. I come from a beautiful paradise named Malaysia.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Lizette Villanueva Jimenez. I am representing Mexico.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Amanda Carter, and I'm representing the land of the long white clouds, New Zealand.
Mago Anglahat, Magandang Gabipo. Ako ay masayang na karatindito. Ako si Adriana Roquer. Ako ay de la Juanput y Santa Ongulan, Mulata, Panama.
My name is Luciana Farfan and I came from the land of the Incas, Peru.
Mabuhay, ako po si Darlene Carbungo, 20 taong gulang, ang inyong mudya ng Pilipinas.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Victoria, I'm 18 years old, I'm with love from Russia.
Salamat. I'm Jasmine. I'm 20 this year, and I'm proud to represent the beautiful island of Singapore.
Ayubowan. My name is Milosha Gamage. I'm 23 years old. I'm from the pearl of the Indian Ocean, Sri Lanka.
I come from Thailand.
Good evening. I'm glad to see you. My name is Tomaszewska Yulia, and I'm happy to represent my country of birth, Ukraine.
Once again, Mr. Gary Valenciano. And now, please meet our program hosts, Ding Dong Dantes and Hans Montenegro.
Good evening. It's the night of beautiful people, and to our lovely candidates, it could yet be the most memorable night of their lives.
That's correct, Ding Dong, because tonight, one of them is going home with the crown on her head as the new Miss Asia Pacific for the year 2001.
You've had a glimpse of our candidates in their respective national costumes, and one of them has just won 20,000 pesos, courtesy of Lipton Iced Tea, for winning the best national costume.
That is correct, and the winner was judged by the Vice President of Marketing for the California Manufacturing Company, makers of Lipton Iced Tea, Mr. Raymond Acedera. Alongside Mr. Acedera, three of the biggest names in Philippine fashion. First, the president of the Asia Pacific Hairdressers and Cosmetologists Association, Mr. Ricky Reyes. Is a distinguished member of the Fashion Designers Association of the Philippines, Mr. Johnny Abad. And third, one of the most sought-after fashion designers of the stars, Mr. Rajo Laurel.
And here is their choice for the best national costume.
Thank you.
is from? From Mexico, Lizette Jimenez.
The award for Best National Costume will be presented by Mr. Raymond Acevedo.
Congratulations, Miss Mexico, for winning Best in National Costume. But the best is yet to come as the candidates go backstage and change into the swimwear for the swimsuit competition of
Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2001. Just stay there. Welcome back. This is the 34th year of the Miss Asia Pacific Quest, the only international beauty pageant that is based here in the Philippines. It was put up by the Filipinos to promote peace, trade, and goodwill among the neighboring countries in the Asia Pacific Rim. But tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we have countries participating not only from the Asian Pacific Basin, but also from the North, South, and Central Americas as well, and also from the Middle East. And here's trivia, ladies and gentlemen. Since 1968, the Philippines has won the crown four times already. Thailand, Australia, and India have each won it three times, while Turkey, Costa Rica, and Korea have each won it twice. Now here's our panel of judges this year that will determine whether the statistics will change in favor of the country that has not won the title yet. Let's meet them.
The Senior Vice President, Managing Director, MTV Asia, MTV Philippines, Mr. Peter Bullard. The Chairman and Chief Executive Officer of the Noble House Group, Mr. Mario Oreta. Fashion Designer, Rajo Laurel. GMA7's Mel Tianco. President and Chief Operating Officer, GMA Marketing and Productions Incorporated, Mr. Roberto Barrero. The Congresswoman of the 1st District of Batangas, the Honorable Aileen Ermita Buhayn. The Governor of the Province of Aklan of the famous Boracay Island, the Honorable Governor Joven Miraflores. The Marketing Director for Home Care Products, Unilever Philippines Incorporated, Mr. Marcel Kirkmista. The Spanish Ambassador to the Philippines, Senor Tomas Rodriguez Pantoja. Presidential Assistant of Harper's Bazaar's 100 Most Beautiful Women of the World, and the Chairman of the Board of Judges, Ms. Ting Ting Gohuanco.
Thank you very much, Board of Judges. And now here's Hans to open the swimsuit competition.
Absolutely, and I couldn't think of a better way to start the beauty quest. As we call out our candidates individually in their official swimsuits, you will notice on the video walls their beauty shots, which were taken by the production crew when our candidates visited the beautiful island of Boracay. Alongside their beauty shots, the official scores of the judges will also be flashed. Ladies and gentlemen, our first set of candidates in their swimsuits, beginning with our candidate from the land down under, Miss Australia.
Miss Australia is 19-year-old Chanel Patricia Gregory. She is 5'7.5" tall and weighs 119 pounds. Her measurements are 34, 25, 36. Miss Colombia, Carolina de la Torre. She is 21 years old, stands 5'5.5" and tips the scales at 110 pounds. Her figure is 35, 24, 35. Miss El Salvador, Sandra Silis Grower. She is 20 years old and is 5'7" tall. She weighs 125 pounds and measures 34, 24 and a half, 36. Miss Honduras, 21-year-old Marcela Rubí. She stands 5'4.5", weighs 120 pounds, and has a body figure of 34, 25, 34. Welcome, Miss India, Maheshwari Thiagarajan. At 21 years, she stands 5'7" and weighs 116 pounds. Her vital statistics are 33.5, 24.5, 35. Candidate is Miss Japan, Naomi Numata. She is 23 years old, 5'4.5" tall, weighs 108 pounds, and measures 34.5, 23.5, 34 and a half. Now for Miss Korea, 23-year-old Jia Kim. She's 5 feet 8 inches tall, weighs 121 pounds, and measures 35, 24, 35. Miss Lebanon is our next candidate, Chantal Pierre Mihana. She is 20 years old, stands 5 feet 5 and weighs 110 pounds. Her figure is 36, 24 and a half, 36. Our last candidate for this group of ladies in their swimsuits is Miss Malaysia, 21-year-old Hu Xiaoyan. Her height is 5 feet 6 inches, weight 106 pounds. Her vital statistics are 33, 24 and a half, 34.
Gentlemen, our first set of candidates in their official swimwear. A big round of applause, please. Ladies, thank you very much. The computerized scoring you are seeing tonight is courtesy of AMA Computer University, the first IT university in Asia. Our second batch of candidates for the swimwear portion of the Miss Asia Pacific when we come back.
Miss Asia Pacific Corp.
Welcome back to the second half of our swimsuit competition for the Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2001. Let's meet our second batch of candidates, beginning with Miss Mexico.
Coming up on stage as well as on your screens is Miss Mexico, Lizette Villanueva Jimenez. She's 5'6½" tall and weighs 121 pounds. Body measurements are 35, 25, 35. Miss New Zealand is our next candidate, Amanda Carter. Amanda is 20 years old, 5'5" tall, and weighs 106 pounds. Her figure is 33, 24 and a half, 34. Next is Miss Panama, 21-year-old Adriana Maricel Roquer. She is 5'8" tall and weighs 125 pounds. Her measurements are 37, 26, 37. Coming up next is Miss Peru, Luciana Virginia Farfan. She is 19 years old, stands 5'8". She weighs 132 pounds, and her figure is a perfect 36, 24, 36. Now it's the turn of our own Miss Philippines, Darlene Zimmer Carbunco. She is 20 years old, stands 5'4" and weighs 112 pounds. Her body figure is 35, 23, 35. Russia is our next lovely candidate, Victoria Goncharova. She is 18 years old, stands tall at 5'11½", and tips the scales at 129 pounds. Her figure is 33 and a half, 25, 35. Taking her turn on center stage is Miss Singapore, Jasmine Xiao Yanling. Jasmine is 20 years old and all of 5'8". She weighs 108 pounds with a vital statistics of 33, 23 and a half, 34. Candidate is Miss Sri Lanka, 23-year-old Nilusha Lakmali Gamage. Stands 5'6", weighs 127 pounds, with body figure of 34, 25, 35. We'll be right back. We now welcome our candidate from Thailand, Wanvisak Kamdangyay. She is 21 years old, stands 5 feet 6 and a half inches, and weighs 114 pounds. She measures 34, 24, 36. Our last candidate is Miss Ukraine, Yulia Gomashevskaya. She is 23 years old, stands 5 feet 10 and a half inches tall, and weighs 132 pounds. Her body measurements are 34, 25, 35.
Ladies and gentlemen, our second batch of candidates in their swimsuits, please, a wonderful round of applause. Thank you very much, ladies. Well, we've certainly turned the heat up this evening with that sizzling swimwear competition, haven't we? When our candidates are on stage, they are at their utmost best, beautiful, poised, calm, and collected. Why don't we take a look at how they are backstage as they mingle with two of the most beautiful and talented ladies in Philippine cinema, Miss Janice and Jelly De Belen.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Ngayon pong gabi, may special privilege kami ng Cisco because we have backstage passes.
Meaning, through us, pwede niyo pong makita ang mga candidates dito sa likod habang nagpa-prepare sila for the next part of the pageant.
Or right after they go off stage, like now.
Wow.
Hi.
Wow.
Hello. Hello. Hello.
Hello. Welcome.
Welcome.
Hello.
Welcome.
Join us.
Join us, please. Join us, please.
Join us, Miss Peru. Well, Miss Peru, what did you enjoy most doing in Boracay?
First, we enjoy everything. We've been in so beautiful beaches. We just, the people were so warm with us. We just have so much fun together.
Thank you very much, Miss Peru.
Thank you very much.
We can go get dressed now. How about Miss Philippines?
Yes, Miss Philippines. Darlene, alika nga dito.
Alika.
Sa opinion mo lang, sino sa inyo ang talagang best in swimsuit?
Best in swimsuit. Lahat.
Lahat? Ikaw naman.
Ikaw naman. Ikaw naman. Magagandang katawan. Lahat sila sexy eh.
Ah, okay. Safe.
Safe.
Oh, sige. Safe. Sige, mag-ready na kayo.
Mag-ready na kayo.
Okay.
At sana ikaw yung maging best in swimsuit.
Alam mo,
sis. Ako sis, meron ako mga bets, pero syempre, hindi ko pwede sabihin. Secret lang yun. Sa akin na lang yun.
Okay, fine. Okay. Anyway, the music used in the swimsuit portion was performed by Pinikpikan from their album, Atas, released by Tao Music.
So thank you to Mr. Billy Bonavie, Mr. Bob Aves, and Miss Grace Nona.
Well, in the meantime, let's see what the one who will be crowned Miss Asia Pacific, has in store for her when she wins.
The winner of the Miss Asia Pacific beauty title will win the grand prize of $10,000 plus these fabulous prizes: 25,000 pesos worth of Samsonite products, 10,000 pesos worth of products each from Avon, Tretorn, and Mosimo, and 5,000 pesos worth of footwear from Alberta Shoes. Miss Asia Pacific's first runner-up will get $2,500 US dollars. 10,000 pesos worth of products each from American Tourister and Mosimo, and 5,000 pesos worth of products each from Alberta Shoes and Tretorn. Our second, third, and fourth runners-up will each win $1,500. 10,000 pesos worth of products from Mosimo, 5,000 pesos worth of products each from Alberta Shoes and American Tourister, and 3,000 pesos worth of products from Tretorn.
Welcome back. I've just been handed two out of the three envelopes containing names of our winners for our special awards by our auditors from SGV. I'm sure our candidates are just as anxious to know whose names are on these envelopes, just as we are. So let's begin. Let me begin by calling the winner of Miss Photogenic. She is the candidate who got the nod of AGFA, the official film of Miss Asia Pacific. Nothing, no nothing escapes AGFA. And Miss AGFA Photogenic is our candidate from Japan, Miss Naomi Numata.
Miss Photogenic wins 100 rolls of AGFA HDC Plus film, one Minolta new Riva Zoom 70 with case, and 20,000 pesos in cash from Photokina Marketing Corporation, the exclusive Philippine distributor of AGFA products. AGFA Films is the official film, and Photo Plus is the official photographers of Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2001. No, nothing escapes AGFA. Presenting the award to Miss Photogenic is Photokina's Vice President for Consumer Imaging, Bong de los Reyes.
Congratulations, Miss Japan. Here now is the winner of a special award from one of our major sponsors, and it is for Miss Avon. Avon Color is the official makeup of Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2001. Avon Color, how do you define beautiful? And our Miss Avon for this evening is Miss Colombia, Carol De La Torre.
Miss Avon wins 10,000 pesos in cash, plus 10,000 pesos worth of Avon products, to be presented to by Avon's brand manager, Miss Dawn Carrion.
Thank you very much, ladies. You may now join your co-contestants in your normal formation. With me now is Mr. Gerard San Victorious from SGV, and he holds the envelope containing the name of the winner for our Best in Swimsuit. Thank you, sir. And our Best in Swimsuit is Miss Mexico, Lizette Villanueva Jimenez.
The Best in Swimsuit wins 10,000 pesos in cash and 10,000 pesos worth of beauty products from Avon. Presenting the award to our winner is the brand manager of Avon Fashions, Ms. Dawn Carrion.
Congratulations to the winners of our special awards, and especially to our Best in Swimsuit, Miss Mexico. Don't go away, the best is yet to come, as the candidates will now gear up for the evening gown competition when we return.
Welcome back. Now all of our candidates are hurriedly changing to their evening gowns. Now for the next major event of our quest for Miss Asia Pacific. You know, ladies and gentlemen, it takes a lot of stamina and hard work to endure the rigors of a contest like this. And our beauty queens have demonstrated in more ways than one that they have what it takes to win the crown. So now let's have a look-see at the kind of schedule the girls have been keeping since they got here in Manila to join the pageant. Let's watch this.
Hi Philippines, mabuhay.
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 Mabuhay everyone.
Mabuhay. Thank you.
I'm sure you were delighted with what you just previewed. Well, the organizers of Miss Asia Pacifica have also made it certain that the girls would have a chance to do a little traveling and sightseeing during their stay here. And they had a chance to do that during their swimsuit photo sessions in Boracay and their talent night that was held at the Island Cove Resort in Cavite. Now let's take a look at the various talents that our candidates demonstrated during their talent night. So watch this.
Thank you.
As they say, you ain't seen nothing yet. Now, talent-wise and beauty-wise, each of our candidates is primed to be the next Miss Asia Pacific. So why don't we find out what's cooking backstage as they're preparing for the evening gown competition.
Sis, these ladies had a busy week pala, oo, no?
Pero kahit na gano sila ka-busy, enjoy pa rin sila kasi ang dami nilang napuntahan. Nag-Island Cove sila, nag-Boracay sila. Enjoy pa rin.
Tapos meron pa silang talent, ang dami nilang... Kakapagod, pero siguro ibang klaseng experience ang nakukuha nila dito.
Oo naman, wala ka ba napapansin? Kasi,
bakit?
Ewan ko, kaninang pinapanood ko siya.
Oh.
Siyempre, nasubaybayan ko, excited ako eh.
Siyempre,
so,
diba?
Natin malaman kung sino nang nanalo ng mga kung ano-anong awards. Is Miss Mexico.
Nakakadalawa na.
Nakakadalawa na.
Correct.
Diba? National costume and best in swimsuit.
Si Miss Japan naman medyo naluha siya talaga.
Naman, syempre diba na-excite siya. Diba? Parang yung pagod niya, parang nag-benefit.
Alam mo, kasama natin dito sa, nandito sila ako naghihintay.
Tanungin kaya natin sila
kung ano bang nararamdaman nila.
Yes.
Kung kamusta ba sila.
Excuse me, girls.
Excuse me. May we interrupt?
Yes. May we join you for a while?
Parang ang sangkat mo dyan, isa.
Oo, kasama nila. You really had a busy week. Did you even have time to relax at all, Miss Singapore?
I feel that despite the tight schedule, I really enjoyed the time in Boracay Island. To me, that was a form of relaxation because we had fun at the beach and stuff. That was the best in Boracay.
Yeah, I would also feel the same.
I'd like to ask Miss Panama. We heard you're into learning the Filipino language. Can you say something in Filipino?
Well, ako ay masayang nakarating dito. Yeah, I cannot speak that much, but certainly I'll try even harder. Since I knew I was coming to the Philippines, I entered the internet and took out a vocabulary. And actually, I got here and everyone just started laughing at me because I couldn't put the words together. But with help of all the Filipinos, and Darlene especially, she helped me a lot too.
Thank you.
Okay, ladies, we won't keep you. We'll see how this link.
Ladies and gentlemen, we present to you our first set of candidates in their exquisite evening gowns. And you can see the detail of their evening gowns even better on our widescreens through our video projectors, courtesy of Microdata. For high impact presentations, there's Microdata, LCD projectors, sound systems, document imaging, video conferencing, Microdata, your total multimedia solution. Now, let's call in Miss Australia. Thank you. us, and ladies and gentlemen, our first set of candidates for the evening gown competition. Now let's see how some of the others are faring backstage with Janice and Jerry.
The first batch did pretty well.
Oh, right. The gowns are so gorgeous and so
Miss
sexy.
Columbia, Dib.
Parang gown mo.
Parang bakit? Sige, show mo. Oh, di ba? Ang sexy.
Ay, ayun na sila. Tatanungin natin.
Okay.
Teka, haabang
ambush.
Aambushin natin sila.
Miss India.
Hi.
Hello, Miss India. You're done with both the swimsuit and the evening gown. How does it feel? Are you sort of relieved or do you feel a little bit more relaxed now?
Not really. In fact, I feel a little more nervous now because I'm nervous. I'm a little more excited because now I know the decision has been made and only the best of us can go on to the next stage. So I'm anticipating, I'm awaiting to see what happens and hope that I'm there.
Wow. So we're also so excited and we're also anticipating. And Miss Australia.
Yes, hello. Miss Australia, you're always first on stage. Is it hard? Does it make you nervous?
No, it just means I have to be more alert and know what I'm doing and know when the counts are. And I'm used to that because I've done a lot of stage performances before, so I can handle it.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Pero sis,
kahit tense yung mga ladies dito ngayon, I noticed yung hair nila, laging mukhang madulas, malambot, at palaging maayos.
Gusto mong malaman kung bakit?
Bakit nga ba?
O, alika, ito ang reason.
Even after a long day, these beauty candidates look smashing.
The hair, it stays manageable day in, day out. It's extraordinarily beautiful.
In spite of a grueling schedule, not one hair's trend is out of place.
Working so hard puts a lot of stress, not just to my body, but also to my hair. But I find a way to keep my hair beautiful in spite of all the stress.
Wherever I am and whatever I do, I'm confident I look good with my hair, as beautiful and manageable as this.
The right foot, we get enough exercise, and of course we use the best products for our hair.
I make sure I use only the best conditioner for my hair, New Advanced Cream Silk Conditioner.
By using the best conditioner, I don't need to worry about fixing my hair. One touch is...
Welcome back. We are now in our second major event on the Miss Asia Pacific Beauty Quest. And the music that you are hearing in the background of this segment is courtesy of Universal Records. That's why we have to acknowledge Miss Belia Tan. All right. And coming up is our next group of candidates led by our candidate from Mexico. Thank you. you, ladies. You all look lovely in your elegant evening gowns, and we know your secret for being standout beauties. We'll pause for this break.
There's more to beauty than what meets the eye. What's the secret to standout beauty? With their perfect figures and graceful posture, any of these beauties can be a winner. But to be a real standout, there's got to be something more.
You need to bring out your beauty with just the right makeup.
Clothes that make you look your best.
A beautiful shiny hair proves your true beauty.
To get gorgeous hair, these girls used new Lux Super Rich Shampoo with breakthrough ingredients that give hair standout shine. Now, those are the secrets that transform these girls into standout beauties. Under the sun or under the spotlights, even the most beautiful women in the world need some help to make...
Ladies and gentlemen, we have our lovely candidates up here on stage waiting for the judges' verdict. And now we will announce the winners of the 10 semi-finalists later on. But in the meantime, we have to announce first the winner of Miss Congeniality. Now, this is the most significant to all our candidates because they have come here to compete in the spirit of friendship and unity. And so they have voted from among themselves the candidate who is most worthy of this title. And the winner of Miss Congeniality is from Sri Lanka, Nilusha Kamali.
Miss Congeniality wins 20,000 pesos in cash from Massimo, the official casual wear of Miss Asia Pacific West 2001, and Massimo Vision, the official eyewear of our beauty candidates. Presenting the award is the Vice President of Promark Industries, official licensee of Massimo, Mr. Rene Go, and Mr. Adamson Bakhtan, Vice President for Productions of Promark Industries.
The ladies here perform during the talent night, but one has exceptionally stood out with the qualities of a vibrant and talented lady. She's not only beautiful, but also one who is dynamic and uniquely divine in character. Miss Talent is Miss Red Bull Supreme Talent, and she is none other than Miss Korea, Jihae Kim.
Miss Korea, the winner of Miss Talent, wins 20,000 pesos in cash, one Minolta camera and 100 rolls of Aqua Films, courtesy of Energy Food and Drinks Incorporated, the exclusive Philippine distributor of Red Bull Supreme Energy Drink, the official energy drink of Miss Asia Pacific West 2001. Presenting the award to Miss Talent, it's Mr. Yen Diao, head coach, PBA Batang Red Bull Thunder Team, and board member of the 1st District of Pampanga.
Thank you and congratulations, girls. Now you may join the rest of your colleagues on stage as we announce the winner of the Best in Evening Gown. And now, the winner of the Best in Evening Gown. Here she is, ladies and gentlemen. The Best in Evening Gown is our candidate from Peru, Luciana Farfan.
The winner of the evening gown competition wins a cash prize of 20,000 pesos from AMA University, the first computer university in Asia. Presenting the award to the best in evening gown is the Vice President for Corporate Communications of AMA Computer University, Mr. Juanito Ramos Jr. Thank you.
Congratulations, Miss Peru. You may now go back and prepare for your next activity. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's pause for this well-deserved break.
Her beauty shines through with a smile. She is friendly and fun to be with. Charm. Easygoing. Relaxed and confident. Above all, she is beautiful up close. Because she has done everything to make sure that her shiny white teeth sparkles and her breath smells confidently clean and fresh. With killer smile, killer fresh breath, and killer confidence, she's definitely a winner. So go on and smile, and the whole world smiles with you.
For those of you who watch beauty pageants regularly, you will know that most of what you see on pageant night has already been prejudged. For instance, Miss Photogenic was chosen by our sponsors from AGFA. Miss Congeniality was nominated by her fellow candidates. And Miss Talent was prejudged on the actual talent competition, which was held several nights ago. The prejudging event is a crucial part of any beauty contest, and this event is held outside the actual pageant night. In it, the candidates do pretty much what you see them doing tonight. They wear their evening gowns, they don their swimsuits, and they are subjected to a very grueling question and answer portion by our board of judges. Having said that, why don't we take a look at some video clips of that event.
The pre-judging for Miss Asia Pacific Quest was held last Monday at the Westin Philippine Plaza, where all of our 19 candidates are billeted. The board of judges for Miss Asia Pacific Quest met the ladies up close for the first time, and this naturally sent the jitters to most of the candidates. The prejudging is composed of several segments. First, the ladies in their pretty cocktail outfits were announced as they walked up to face the judges. Here, they introduced themselves individually to the judges and made their standard beauty poses. In this portion of the prejudging activity, the judges score the girls according to the beauty of face. Next, the girls changed from their cocktail dresses into their swimsuits. Actually, this is where the judges rated the candidates on their body figures and picked out their choice for the title of Best in Swimsuit. After the swimsuit event, the girls were now on to the interview portion. Unlike on pageant night, where the girls are asked only one or two questions by a judge, here, a candidate was addressed by two or more judges with questions ranging from the simple boy-to-girl next-door questions to politically charged issues. And here, the candidates were scored according to their total beauty and personality. The worst over. The girls were now grouped by the beauty pageant sponsors for further scrutiny. Here, representatives from each sponsoring product made their choices for their special awards. In this case, the winners for Miss Lux, Miss Avon, Miss Close-Up, Miss Ponds, and Miss Cream Silk. Of course, the lucky winners were kept secret, and their names would be announced during coronation night of Miss Asia Pacific. To the beauty candidate, the prejudging was the pageant's make or break event, the one that determined if they indeed have a pretty good chance at winning the crown. And here is how the candidate scored at the prejudging event.
Well, now, for those of you who are keeping tabs on how each candidate is doing, here's the breakdown of their scores. 60% will come from their prejudging event, 30% from the swimsuit portion, and 10% from the evening gown competition. With that, you have a general idea of who is going to make it into the magic circle of 10 semifinalists. As the candidates are keeping their fingers crossed, let's join Janice and Jelly backstage.
Wow, tapos na ang evening gown competition. Uh-oh. Alam mo, kanina nga nakikita ko siya lumalakad, siya suot niya yung gown niya, talagang sabi ko, sana maisuot ko yan.
One day.
Pero very, very elegant siya.
Kasi Miss Peru. Ikaw ba, dream mong maging beauty queen?
I've always enjoyed watching pageants, pero after what I saw dun sa prejudging,
hirap na nakaka-nervyos.
Hindi ko ata kakayanin yung ano, pressure.
Oo, wag na lang. Okay na tayo.
May katabi tayo dito ng mga naka-outfit na ng mga candidates na medyo pwede nating tanongin.
Sige, sige nga.
Puntahan natin sila. Hi! Miss New Zealand and Miss Malaysia.
Yes, Miss Malaysia, this is a nice
number. Gusto ko lang malaman nyo na pwede nating katukin ang kanilang outfit.
Baka may sumagot. Anyway, what was the prejudging like? Were you very nervous?
No. Just relax. Because I know that I'll be prejudging before the contest.
Okay.
I'd like to ask Miss New Zealand, what do you think your chances are of winning?
Well, there are so many beautiful girls. And to tell you the truth, I don't know. There is one particular person that they're looking for. I may be it, hopefully. Hopefully for my country. I think pretty good. Well, 1 in 19. Anyway.
Yeah, 1 in 19 chance. Yeah,
well,
I think so.
I think you're both practicing for your dance number, so we won't keep you.
Yes.
We won't keep you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Having flawless skin is a plus point. And here's the reason kung bakit po lahat ng mga kandidato eh flawless ang skin. Ito na po.
Healthy, rosy white skin that's noticeably radiant. That's the Pond's Institute promise. Improving your skin complexion goes a surprisingly long way in enhancing your looks. The way to really healthy, rosy white skin is simple. Cleanse and nourish in the morning, then deep clean and nourish at night. Each morning, cleanse your skin with a facial wash to keep your skin soft and smooth. And nourish your skin with a vitamin B3 cream that contains double sun shields for gentle whitening and protection from the sun's rays throughout the day. Keep your matte finish looking fresh and radiant despite your hectic schedule through an occasional buff of facial powder. Finally, at night, deep cleanse deep-seated dirt with cold cream. Then give your skin a treat by applying a...
Ladies and gentlemen, here they are with an extraordinary performance together. One World, One Nation, choreographed by the Philippines' best choreographer, Christine Blando. The candidates for Miss Asia Pacific West 2001.
Everybody go!
For high-impact presentations, there's Microdata. LCD projectors, sound systems, document imaging, video conferencing. Microdata, your total multimedia solution. Our quest continues for Miss Asia Pacific 2001 after this short break.
We're back, and here are our candidates once again in their breathtaking swimsuits. Okay, guess what, ladies and gentlemen? I've just been handed the names of those who made it to the semifinals. There are 10 of them. Let me start by calling Miss Lebanon, Chantal Mehana. Our second finalist is from Mexico, Lizette Jimenez. Let's give way for Miss Colombia, Carol de la Torre. Next, we have New Zealand, Amanda Carter. Our fifth finalist is from Panama, Adriana Roker. To join the rest is from the country of Peru, Luciana Farfan. Next on the list is from El Salvador, Sandra Glower. And our eighth finalist is from Thailand, Won Visa Kham Dang Yai. We have two more to go, and to step into the ninth circle is from the country, our very own from the Philippines, Darlene Tarbungo. And to complete them all is from the country of Korea, Jihei Kim. Mm-hmm. are, ladies and gentlemen, our 10 semi-finalists for Miss Asia Pacific. And from this stunning line of beauties, our major sponsors from Unilever Philippines have also chosen their special awardees. And here's Hans to announce those special awards.
Thank you very much, Ding Dong. Let's go on to the special awards. Let me first announce the winner of the special title of Miss Lux Super Rich Standout Beauty, the woman whose beauty stands out from the rest because of her shiny hair. She has that standout shine that only Lux Super Rich Shampoo can give. And our sponsor's choice is Miss... Peru, Luciana Farfan.
Miss Lux Super Rich Standout Beauty wins 20,000 pesos in cash from Lux. Presented by the brand manager of Lux Super Rich Shampoo, Miss Colette Reyes.
Congratulations, Miss Peru. Our next special award is for Miss Pond's rosy white skin. The lady with skin that's noticeably rosy white, her skin radiantly glows from Pond Skin Vitamin Cream and fluid for rosy white skin that makes all the difference. And the presenter's choice for Miss Pond's rosy white skin is... Miss Colombia, Carol de la Torre.
Miss Pond's rosy white skin wins 20,000 pesos in cash from Pond's, presented by the brand manager of Pond's, Mr. Pablo Indaya.
Congratulations, Miss Colombia. Our third award is Miss Cream Silk. The woman with the most extraordinarily beautiful hair, beauty that only Cream Silk conditioner can give. Cream Silk conditioner, sa sobrang dulas ng buhok, isang haplos lang, ayos na. And Miss Cream Silk is none other than... Miss Mexico, Lizette Villanueva Jimenez.
Miss Cream Silk will receive 20,000 pesos in cash from Cream Silk. Presented by the brand manager of Cream Silk, Mr. Adam Pineda.
Special award is for Miss Close-Up Killer Confident Smile. For the woman with a winning close-up smile, a woman who stands tall, walks with grace, and exudes the killer confidence to get her that winning crown. And the unanimous choice of our presenter is our candidate from the Philippines, Miss Darlene Carpunco. Close-up, get that killer smile, killer fresh breath, killer confidence.
Miss Close-Up Killer Confident Smile wins 20,000 pesos in cash and 1 year supply of Close-Up Toothpaste. Presented by the brand manager of Close-Up Toothpaste, Mr. Ralph Kalinisan.
Congratulations, girls, and thank you very much to Unilever for those special awards. A closer look at our 10 semi-finalists when we return to the Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2001.
We'd just like to make a correction about the one who presented one of the special awards earlier. The one who presented the award for Miss Pond's rosy white skin was the brand manager of Pond's, Miss Angela Reyes. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here's our first group of semi-finalists. So let's get to know them better. Let's start off with Miss Lebanon. Hello, you can pick your question from the bowl. Translating for Miss Lebanon is Mr. Sharif Altayeb. Here's your question. What is your greatest dream? If you had to give it up for something, what would it be?
إيش هو أكبر حلم لك في حياتك؟ وإذا فرض عليك إنك أنت تتخلي عنه، إيش ممكن يكون الشيء اللي تسيبي عنه الحلم هذا؟ إيش هو أكبر حلم لك في حياتك؟ وإذا فرض عليك إنك تتخلي عن هذا الحلم، تسيبيه مشان إيش؟ ايش الشيء اللي ممكن تسيب عشانه هذا الحلم او تتركيه؟
Well, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to answer in English, but I will not because I'm French educated, so I'll answer in my own language. للحقيقة الحلم يلي هو غالي كتير على قلبي ويلي كنت بحلم وصلي 6 سنين عم بشتغل على انه حققه هو إنه قوم بجمعية بتقوم بحقوق الأطفال كلها لأنه حقوق الأطفال هن أهم حقوق وبالأخص ثقافتهم وأعلى درجة ثقافة لأنه الثقافة هي يلي بتولد جيل متين بيقدر يكون مستقبل ماهر لإلنا والشي الوحيد يلي بيعقول يخليني إنه أتخلى عن هالحلم هيدا هو إذا دخلت إرادة الله والله بطل نعم علي بصحة جيدة وبنعمة مثل هيدي فشكرا Thank you ladies and gentlemen سلام أبو
The biggest dream in my life is to create an organization for children charity to help them study and to help them make up, do their life in the best way possible. And the only thing that which I could leave my dream or desert my dream is if I have a health problem or if I lose my health. That's the only way that I could abandon my dream or forget about it.
Thank you very much, Ms. Lebanon. Next, let's call on Ms. Mexico, Lizette Villanueva Jimenez. And we'll have Mr. Alfredo Robles Jr. with her to translate. Hello, how are you? ¿Cómo estás?
I'm fine, thank you. Gracias, muy bien.
All right, you may now pick your question from the bowl. Okay, here's your question. What do you think is the biggest problem in our environment? And what can you do to help?
¿Cuál es, en su opinión, el mayor problema ambiental en el mundo actual y qué haría para solucionar este problema?
Bueno, yo creo que el problema más importante que tenemos ahora en la actualidad es el de la guerra, que está ocasionando pues mucha mala interpretación ante todos los países. Yo creo que la paz es lo primordial para tener una comunicación más plena, más sana con todo mundo. Yo creo que la paz es lo más importante que puede tener un ser humano. Yo creo que eso es lo importante que tiene y que vale la persona por lo que es. Yo creo que eso es lo más importante. Muchísimas gracias.
I believe that the most important problem that we have that does great damage to the environment is the problem of war. It is a very serious problem, and it is one that can be solved with communication. And I believe that peace is the supreme good in this earth, and for this reason, I believe that it is war that does damage to the environment that is the most serious problem.
Thank you very much, Mr. Robles. Gracias. All right, let's call our next Miss Colombia, Carol Inés de la Torre. How are you feeling? ¿Cómo estás?
Bien, gracias. ¿Y tú?
Bien. All right. Again, we have Mr. Alfredo Robles Jr. with us. Here's your question. What social tradition would you like to preserve in your country, and why?
¿Qué tradición social en su país desearía conservar, y cuál es la razón por la cual desearía conservar esta tradición social?
La tradición más importante, ante todo, muy buenas noches, la tradición más importante que tiene mi país es la unión familiar. Siempre hay una cabeza de familia, siempre hay una madre, siempre hay unos hijos que la conforman, y yo creo que la familia es la base de todo y es lo que hace que el mundo cada día marche mejor, porque los padres a nosotros nos inculcan mucha educación, una educación excelente, y eso es lo que nos hace los buenos hombres del mañana. Yo considero que la tradición más importante que tiene mi país es la unión familiar. Gracias.
I believe that the most important social tradition that I would wish to conserve in my country is the tradition of family solidarity. There is always a head of the family in this tradition. There is a mother. The family is the basis of society, and it is the institution that inculcates values and principles, and it is for this reason that I would want to conserve the family as the most important social tradition.
Thank you again, Mr. Robles, and thank you, Ms. Colombia. Next, let's call Ms. New Zealand. Hello, Amanda. Are you feeling good tonight?
Very good.
I can see that. You can now pick your question from the board. All right. Who is a person that has been influential in your life, and why?
There has been a number of people who have been influential in my life. The lady who I'd like to thank for sending me to this pageant is Val Lott. She has meant a lot to me and was the person that I was the reason that I joined the pageant in the first place about 4 years ago. I would like to thank her a lot for her strength, her generosity, and all the hard work that she's put into us girls, into New Zealand. She has meant a lot to us. She's been a friend. She is a person that we have grown to love. She is so strong, and she is willing to give anyone a chance, and I believe that is really, really important.
Thank you very much, Ms. Carter. Next is called on Ms. Panama. You know, you were so amazing when you did that Filipino thing earlier. Could you give us one more sample of that?
Ako ay masayang nakarating dito.
Masaya rin kami nakarating ka dito. You may put your question from the board. Do you want it in Filipino, Spanish, or? Anyway, if you were applying for a job, what would you tell your new boss about yourself?
Si usted debiera presentar una solicitud para un puesto de trabajo, ¿qué diría a su futuro jefe sobre sí misma?
I believe that first of all, I would say it's giving my first and my diploma. Obviously, I believe that is the most important thing for everyone in trying to get a job. Actually, I believe in respect. I believe in mutual and believing in getting along, trying to communicating jobs, making the job not just a difficult task. I believe a job is to learn of others, to get experience. And actually, I just would say my boss to trust me. I know I would definitely won't let him down. I believe in my education, and my college degree must talk for it.
Thank you, once again, Mr. Robles, very well said. Thank you, ladies. Now that should prime you for the final question and answer portion. Now let's see how the other group is doing backstage with Janice and Jerry.
Sis, yung question and answer portion daw ang make or break part ng pageant.
Siyempre naman.
Okay, we're back with our other five semi-finalists. Earlier, Ding Dong had the pleasure of interviewing the first five. Now it's my turn. Let's begin with Miss Peru. Luciana Virginia Farfan. Hola, Luciana. ¿Cómo estás?
Muy bien.
Saca un tarjeta, por favor. Gracias. Here's your question. How would you like the other candidates to remember you after the contest? Once again, how would you like the other candidates to remember you after the contest?
Desea una traducción, sí. ¿Qué opinión desea una traducción? Sí. ¿Qué opinión desearía que las candidatas se llevasen a su casa a propósito de usted?
Let me tell you, but for me, it was really hard to be here because it's my first pageant, and I was really nervous, and everything for me was really hard. What I want to the girls remember of me, that at first time, I think I was gonna admit it. I was not gonna able to handle this, but just because of these girls, I get the strong enough, and I'm here standing up with you guys because I get the strength, and I want these girls thinking about me that I get this train and I'm strong enough to be here talking to you. Thank you.
Muchas gracias, Luciana. Our next candidate, Miss El Salvador. Sandra Silis Glory. Here's your question. In your opinion, what would make a perfect home? Again, in your opinion, what would make a perfect home?
En su opinión, ¿cuáles son los factores que se dan a la base de un hogar perfecto?
Bueno, para empezar, para un hogar perfecto es la familia, porque la familia es la base de la sociedad. Y una familia y un hogar perfecto solamente se puede dar con una unión. Una unión es lo más importante en la familia ni en el hogar. Y un balance y un equilibrio. Eso es lo que da la unión. Un balance y el equilibrio para que la sociedad y todos los valores vengan de la familia en una forma positiva.
I believe that at the base of the perfect home is the family that is characterized by solidarity and union. But within the family, there should be also a balance so that society can have stability. And it is for this reason that I believe that it is the family that is at the base of a perfect home.
Thank you.
Muchas gracias, señorita Glow. Our third semifinalist, Miss Thailand. One visa, Kwan Dang Yai. Please take your question. What is the one thing you would like to take with you to your country from the Philippines? What is the one thing you would like to take with you back to your country from the Philippines?
ถ้าคุณสามารถที่จะนำสิ่งใดสิ่งหนึ่งกลับไปจากฟิลิปปินส์กลับไปที่เมืองไทยเนี่ยสิ่งนั้นจะคืออะไรเดี๋ยวอีกครั้งหนึ่งนะครับถ้าคุณสามารถที่จะนำสิ่งของสิ่งใดสิ่งหนึ่งจากฟิลิปปินส์กลับไปที่ประเทศไทยสิ่งของสิ่งนั้นคืออะไร
ถ้าอยากจะนำกลับไปใช่ไหมคะอยากจะนำรอยยิ้มความประทับใจที่ได้พบได้เจอผู้คนที่นี่เพราะว่าผู้คนที่นี่เนี่ยมีรอยยิ้มที่จริงใจอยากจะนำกลับไปที่เมืองไทยด้วยค่ะแล้วก็อาจจะถ้าเป็นสิ่งของก็อยากจะนำเปลือกหอยสวยๆเนี่ยกลับไปเพราะว่าที่ฟิลิปปินส์เนี่ยมีชายหาดที่สวยงามมากหลายแห่งเหมือนกันก็ประทับใจทุกที่เลยค่ะ
What I would like to bring home is a smile and the friendliness from the Filipinos people, because she has met a lot of people with nice smile and friendliness. And I would like also to bring back beautiful things from the Philippines, because Philippines has a lot of nice, beautiful things.
Thank you very much, Miss Thailand. Our fourth semi-finalist, Miss Philippines, Darlene Zimmer Carbunco. Here's your question, Darlene. What do you think is the biggest hindrance to having world peace? What do you think is the biggest hindrance to having world peace?
I think the biggest hindrance to world peace is the lack of respect of people to other people, because I think if you have respect to other people, it doesn't matter who you are or where you're from or what your religion is. It is who you are, and it is that we are all human and we are all brothers in this world. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Darlene. Our last semi-finalist, Miss Korea, Miss Jie Kim. If you were escorting a special guest in your country, where would you take him? If you were escorting a special guest in your country, where would you take him?
만약 아주 특별한 손님이 한국에 오신다면 어느 곳으로 그분을 모시고 가시고 싶습니까?
예비 심사 때도 말씀드렸지만 저희 나라는 내년에 2002년 월드컵을 일본과 함께 개최합니다. 그래서 지금 축구 경기장을 짓고 있는데요. 지금 완공되어 있는 축구 경기장에 데리고 가서 저희 나라가 얼만큼 준비를 열심히 하고 있는지 보여드리고 싶습니다. 그것이 제가 이 대회에 한국 대표로 참가한 이유 중에 하나이기 때문입니다.
Well, as we all know, our country, Republic of Korea, we're gonna held World Cup 2002 next year. So that's the only reason I joined this competition or contest to promote the Republic of Korea. So I'd like to bring my special guest to the special place, which is our soccer court or the soccer player.
Thank you very much, Miss Korea. Well, there you have it. All the ladies were fantastic. Thank you, ladies. I'm sure the judges are having a very hard time picking the special five from among the 10. Why don't we join Janice and Jelly backstage as the candidates change into their long gown competition?
Do you think nina-nervous pa sila?
Of course naman, Jelly. Ikaw ba hindi ka nina-nervousin? Dahil inawal, i-announce na ang five finalists. And from that five finalists, one will be crowned Miss Asia Pacific.
Friends, for the pleasure of our 10 semi-finalists, here once again is our special guest, the Philippine record industry's best vocal performer for 2000, Mr. Gary Valenciano.
I will be here.
will be I will be here.
Thank you very much, Mr. Gary Valenciano. What a touching song. Philippine entertainment can never be the same without you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, one more leap before the final moment. Okay, here are our five finalists for Miss Asia Pacific 2001. Please take the first lead. Miss Thailand, Wan Visa Kam Dang Yai. And now, let's call on Miss Peru, Luciana Farfan. Next on the list, we have Miss Colombia, Carol De La Torre. Our fourth finalist is from the country of Mexico, Lizette Jimenez. And to complete the five finalists is Darlene Carbunco of the Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, we have our top five finalists before you now. Thank you, ladies. You've done the most wonderful and noteworthy job representing your countries. And we are all very proud of you. Let's all give them a warm round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, let us pause for this drink. Welcome back. Now, ladies, it's question and answer time. Only one question for all of you. Now, you know that there will be an interpreter standing beside you just in case you'll be needing one. Okay. I'll have our first finalist here with me while the rest of you can go up there and cover your pretty little ears with the headphones. Let's start with Miss Thailand. Her translator is Mr. Apinad Rothana Vibat. Okay. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world? I will repeat the question. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world?
ถ้าคุณชนะการประกวดมิสเอเชียแปซิฟิกครั้งนี้คุณจะช่วยแนะนำหรือส่งเสริมจุดเด่นของภาคพื้นเอเชียแปซิฟิกนี้ให้โลกเห็นได้อย่างไรอีกครั้งหนึ่งนะครับถ้าคุณชนะการประกวดมิสเอเชียแปซิฟิกครั้งนี้คุณจะช่วยส่งเสริมหรือแนะนำจุดเด่นของภาคพื้นเอเชียแปซิฟิกนี้ให้โลกได้เห็นได้อย่างไร
ค่ะก็จะนำเสนอในเรื่องของความมีน้ำใจของของคนในภาคพื้นนี้นะคะเพราะว่าในการที่มาประกวดมิสเอเชียแปซิฟิกเนี่ยแล้วก็การได้มาเก็บตัวที่ประเทศฟิลิปปินส์เนี่ยเราก็ได้แลกเปลี่ยนอะไรหลายๆอย่างกับผู้เข้าประกวดทั้งหมดเราได้รู้ว่าผู้เข้าประกวดแต่ละชาตินั้นเป็นยังไงเราก็ได้ศึกษามาหมดแล้วก็คิดว่าจะส่งเสริมในเรื่องของความมีน้ำใจความอบอุ่นของชาวภาคพื้นเอเชียนี้ค่ะขอบคุณค่ะ
When I first came here I represent ThailandAnd if I win Miss Asia Pacific, I will certainly represent the whole region of Asia Pacific because when I came here, I have actually exchanged and met a lot of my friends, a lot of contestants, and I understand the culture, the warmness, and the friendliness of our people in the Asia Pacific. And these are the points that I will show it to the world. The friendliness, the warmness,the nice, beautiful smile of people in Asia Pacific.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Ms. Thailand. Next finalist is called on Miss Peru. Hi, Luciana. Are you nervous?
Yes.
Okay. Here's your question.If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world? I shall repeat. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world?
Si usted ganara el concurso de Miss Asia Pacific, ¿qué haría usted para promover la imagen de la región en el resto del mundo?
What I would do, you know, that when I get invited to come here,I was really worried because we know that there's a lot of problems about the war, but I get the sacrifice and I came here to prove my country that there is no problems here, that we are fine, that
we know that violence just generate more violence, but Filipino person had no violence. I didn't feel at all this. I was feeling so good. We and all the girls was feeling so good and so comfortable. What I can take to my people, I want to take to my people that this is a wonderful place, it is saved. There's a lot of beautiful places that we can came. That's all I can say to my country. We are here really good, in good hands with the Filipino people. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Bay. Next, let's call on Miss Colombia, Carol Ines de la Torre, with, of course, her translator, Mr. Alfredo Robles Jr. Hello? Here's your question. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world?
Si usted ganara el concurso Miss Asia Pacific, ¿qué haría usted para promover la imagen de la región en el resto del mundo?
Si yo ganara Miss Asia Pacific esta noche, sería un gran honor para mí. En este momento yo estudio comunicación social y periodismo. Y con la ayuda de la televisión, comenzaría primero en mi país y luego recorrería cada parte del mundo con la ayuda de todos los pertenecientes a Filipinas, porque este país es muy lindo y me gustaría llevar muchas cosas de él al exterior. Entonces, con mi belleza, con mi intelecto, y ahora Filipinas es mi segundo hogar, sé que voy a llegar muy lejos y voy a mostrar lo lindo que tiene Filipinas, sus hermosas playas, sus bellos lugares y lo más importante, el corazón de cada persona perteneciente a Filipinas, porque yo lo llevo en mi corazón. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Miss Colombia.
It would be a very great honor for me if I won the Miss Asia Pacific contest. In my country, I studied communication and journalism, and also I appear on television. Therefore, I would first publicize, promote the Asia Pacific in my own country, and I would promote each part of the Philippines in my country. This country is very beautiful. There are many beautiful things in this country. The Philippines is now my second home, and therefore, it has many beautiful beaches, it has many beautiful places. And most of all, the most beautiful thing is the heart of the Filipino, and I have left my heart in the Philippines.
Thank you also, Mr. Robles. Okay, let's call him Ms. Mexico, Lizette Villanueva Jimenez. Hello, Ms. Mexico. I'll repeat the question again. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world?
Si usted ganara el concurso de Miss Asia Pacific, ¿qué haría usted para promover la imagen de la región en el resto del mundo?
Bueno, antes que nada, yo considero este concurso de primera calidad. Este concurso es muy bonito, muy lindo para todas las participantes como las que vemos aquí. Yo creo que este concurso es maravilloso. Es un triunfo para mi vida estar aquí. Yo creo que no cualquiera puede estar aquí delante de todos ustedes y demostrarle y traerle la cultura de cada país, de cada región, de cada región de este mundo, que es maravilloso. Bueno, yo promovería, bueno, a mí me encantó Filipinas, yo creo que es un país increíble, la gente es tan calurosa, promovería su cultura, la cultura es tan bella que me encanta. Yo voy a darlo a conocer a México, soy la embajadora primordial para darle a conocer la cultura filipina. Gracias.
First of all, I would like to say that this contest is a beautiful experience for all of the contestants. It is a marvelous experience, and if I won, it would be a triumph for me. I would like to demonstrate in my own country the culture of each country and of the Asia Pacific and also of the Philippines, because the Philippines is an incredible country. The people are so warm and the culture is beautiful. I am an ambassador of my country, but I also consider myself an ambassador of the Philippines.
That was from Miss Mexico, ladies and gentlemen. And to complete our final five, let's call on Darlene Garbunco. Hello, darling. This is your question. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world? I will repeat. If you win as Miss Asia Pacific, how would you promote this region to the rest of the world?
Well, first of all, I think by joining this pageant, I think I've already done enough to help promote Philippines to the other Asian countries. Second of all, if I win Miss Asia Pacific, I think what I will do is to work with other countries to improve our economies, which are actually interrelated with each other. So I think that will do a lot to help our economy. And third of all is to just strengthen the friendships within other countries of the rest of the world. Thank you.
Thank you very much. So that completes our final five, ladies and gentlemen. We're almost at the end of our quest. You have made your choices and so have our judges. So let's see if they... Welcome back. It's been an exciting year for the Miss Asia Pacific 2000. And now we are ready to crown the new queen of the Asia Pacific. And here are the distinguished guests who will do us the honor of conferring the titles to our five winning finalists. Hans?
Right you are. Presenting the award to our fourth runner-up is 1995 Mutiana Pilipinas Maricel Morales Espinosa with Mr. Rajo Laurel and Mr. Mario Oreta. The third runner-up title will be presented by 1989 Miss Asia Pacific Lorna Legaspi Lopez together with Mr. Roberto Barrero and Mr. Peter Bullard. The award for second runner-up will be presented also by Maricel Morales Espinosa together with Ms. Mel Tianco and Mr. Joven Miraflores. The first runner-up will be awarded by Ms. Lorna Legaspi Lopez together with Ambassador Tomas Rodriguez Pantoja and Representative Aileen Ermita Buhain. And the new Miss Asia Pacific will be crowned by Lorna Legaspi Lopez together with Mr. Marcel Kirkmeister and Ms. Tingting Cojuangco. Aside from that, here's what's in store for our fourth, third, and second runners-up. Each will win 5,000 pesos worth of Alberto shoes, 5,000 pesos worth of products from American Tourister, 3,000 pesos worth of products from Tretorn, and 10,000 pesos worth of products from Mossimo, and last but not the least, $1,500 in cash.
All right. And now, for our fourth runner-up, our fourth runner-up is from the Philippines, Darlene Carbugo.
Now we move on to our third runner-up. And our third runner-up is Miss Colombia, Carol de la Torre.
And our second runner-up is Miss Thailand, Wan Visa Kamdangyay. All right, who among the two ladies you see there will be the next Miss Asia Pacific? I have the name of our winning candidate, but the name that I will call out first is the one that will occupy the first runner-up position. So don't be confused now, okay? The first runner-up will get 5,000 pesos worth of shoes from Alberto's, 5,000 pesos worth of products from Tretorn, 10,000 pesos worth of products from Mossimo, 10,000 pesos worth of products from American Tourister, and $2,500 in cash. All right, the first runner-up occupies a very important position because she automatically takes the place of the winner in case she's not able to perform her duties as Miss Asia Pacific. Ladies and gentlemen, the first runner-up is our candidate from Mexico, Lizette Jimenez.
And Miss Peru is Miss Asia Pacific 2001. Congratulations, Miss Peru, you are Miss Asia Pacific 2001. Miss Peru has just won $10,000 in cash, 25,000 pesos worth of shoes from Samsonite, $10,000 worth of products each from Mossimo, Tretorn, and Avon, and 5,000 pesos worth of products from Alberto Shoe.
Girls, dry up their tears. Let me, Hans, Janice, and Jelly here thank you for being with us on this beautiful quest.
But before we say goodnight, we would like to thank our presenters, New Lux Super Rich Shampoo, now with breakthrough ingredients so you can get that standout shine.
Pond Skin Whitening Vitamin Fluid and Cream for rosy white skin that makes all the difference.
New Advanced Cream Silk Conditioner. Sa sobrang tulas at lambot ng buhok, isang haplos lang, ayos na.
Close-up toothpaste. Get killer smile, killer fresh breath, and killer confidence from all new germ-killing close-up.
I really enjoyed tonight's show.
Yes, I'd really like to thank the both of you for adding just the right amount of sisterly warmth and love backstage to make the candidates more at ease. It's been a beautiful night, and I hope that our 19 candidates not only visit the Philippines as candidates, but eventually as visitors as they continue to promote the Asia-Pacific region. Ladies and gentlemen, from the NBC tent, this has been Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2001. We'll see you again next year for Miss Asia Pacific Quest 2002.
Thank you.
Stop!